Did you know that there are 4 different techniques that you could use to create almost any kind of Figma carousel? Well, surprise, there is. And in this video, I will show you how to use all of them so that you can recreate basically any kind of carousel that you find on the web. If you want to follow along, the Figma file will be linked down below. Now, let's get into it. So when it comes to creating carousels inside of Figma, the first thing we need to do is to create the base, which is to create the carousel items. So as you can see here, I have created an item, or actually 4 of them, called image plus text. So in this, we have an image and we have a text field. I've wrapped those into an auto layout. If you don't know how to use auto layouts, check out this video. So pause this one, check out this video, because auto layouts are super helpful in carousel cases like this, where we handle a bunch of different items. So I've wrapped this into an auto layout. Then I've duplicated this carousel item. As you can see here, different images, different text fields. Now, the next step would be to take all of these and wrap all of these into an auto layout by themselves. So we have another auto layout made up out of several auto layouts. Crazy inception stuff. So I will call this carousel. So this is gonna be our carousel. I will drag this down into the desktop container here. And now we've done most of the work, really. I will take this desktop frame and drag this over to the next step, which brings us to the first type of carousel that we can create. And I call this the basic carousel because this one doesn't require anything else but us changing a couple of settings. So the first thing I would do for this to work would be to place it in the edge here and drag down the width of my auto layout here. I would go to the design settings, make sure that it's aligned to the top left. This will be important in the next step, which you will see in a bit. And that's almost all the things we have to do. I'm just gonna change the horizontal padding as well to 56 so that we have this little spacing here to the left. And for us to have this spacing on the right as well, I'm actually not gonna change the padding anymore. I'm gonna go here to the width and say minus 56. So the same number that we used for the padding so that we have it being cut off. And you will see why that matters in just a sec here. We're almost done at this point. I'm just gonna change the constraint settings here as well. So I'll change from left to left and right, which helps us if we want to make this into a mobile carousel. We still maintain the same width here. You can see that we still have the padding of 56 to the right and the padding of 56 to the left. So once that's done, the last step is to go into prototype here, go to overflow and change from no scrolling to horizontal. So I'll go to desktop or to our frame, add the flow starting point, lay the prototype, and now we have a carousel. And this is the most basic carousel, like I said. It isn't fancy, but it works. And you can see here, we have the spacing to the right here. If we didn't add this spacing here, if we didn't change the width of the container, then we're gonna end up with this, where it just touches the right edge like this. So that's why that's important. If we move over to the next step and we want to create something that is a bit more fancy, in this case, we're gonna create an on-drag carousel. So like the basic one, but it's gonna be a bit cooler. So if I click here, on play, you can see here that we have some more stuff happening in this carousel. We have some elevation, we have some fade-ins and fade-outs. It's a bit cooler, right? And it also takes a bit more effort to create these kinds of carousels. So the first thing we wanna do is to go back to our container here and change the overflow settings to be no scrolling. The second step is to duplicate our frame. First, we could do some tweaks again. I am gonna, first of all, just remove the padding. I'm gonna move this to the center like this so that we mimic this layout. So we have the first item starting in the center like this. The second item, I want to be pulled down a bit. And if you remember, I changed the alignment of this overall carousel from center or align left to align top left. If it's align left and I go into a carousel item to change the vertical padding because I want to create this elevation that we saw in the previous example, or in the actual prototype example here, you can see that everything inside of this auto layout is gonna be pulled down. Now, if we change the overall carousel here to be top align left or align top left, you can see that it's just this item that gets pulled down. I will do this for each and every item. So the next one is gonna be 56 times 2. The third one, or the fourth one actually, is gonna be 56 times 3 instead. That's how we get that elevation. All of them, except for the active one, is gonna be 25% in opacity. The active one is gonna be the one that has 100% in opacity. Now I'm gonna duplicate this frame once. I won't do all of the steps for this one. I will just show you the techniques that you need. So for the second step, we would move all of this to the center. Like this, I think that looks like the center. I would take this first item, or the item that was the active one, but that goes to left, change the vertical padding to 56, so pushes it down. I will fade it out, 25% in opacity. I will take this, set it to 0 in vertical padding. The second item will be 56, and, or the third actually, and the fourth one will be 56 times 2. Like this, and we just fade this one in. That's the second state. Now, how do we create the actual interaction? Well, we go to the carousel here, because the carousel is the thing we're interacting with. So click the carousel, click prototype, then we can go here, click the plus sign, drag it to the second step, change from on click to on drag, and then do the same from this one. This one back to the first, on click to on drag instead. And now if we play it, we have that same elevation happening. Super smooth. And that's all you need to do. Now, like I said, if you want to do the full carousel, you would just repeat this. All of the steps that you have, or all of the slides, or all of the carousel items you have inside of your carousel, repeat it for each one. Now we're going to take this and move on to the next one, which is on-click carousels. So in this case, we have a button that we can use to navigate through our carousel, like this. And the technique is rather similar. So what we would do, first of all, I will remove these interactions, like this, so we don't have the previous interactions that I added. I will take these buttons, copy them over here, and I will remove the interaction that was already on the button. I will take this and paste it in here too, and I will make this 100% in opacity, because once you slide it once, you can go both ways. So both of them should be highlighted. What we want to do now is to add the interaction to the buttons. So instead of having it on the carousel, I'm gonna go to the button, drag from here to this, have on click instead of on drag, and then from this one back to the first one, on click instead of on drag, I'll click play. Now if I click, works in the same way, same animation, but we do it on a click instead. Now the last thing we're gonna do is to have a carousel that is automatic. So in this carousel, we don't have to click anything. It's all gonna be by itself. It's gonna change the carousel item by itself. What we do here in this case is we target the top frame. So in this case, desktop here. Target this, we go to the sides here, so we get the plus sign. We drag this to the next one. And instead of on click, I will change this to after delay. And 800 milliseconds is fine. I will do the same from this back to the first one. So if we play this, you can see that we have the same animation, except for the fact that for the second one, I had on click. So make sure you have after delay, click after delay, and now it goes back and forth like this. Now, if you're into Figma animations, I suggest you check out my playlist where I go through a bunch of different techniques for Figma animations. Until the next one, have a great life. We'll talk soon. Ciao.